We all know that Facebook, Amazon, and Google know a lot about you, sometimes to a degree that's creepy and big brothery.
A lot of other companies are tracking you too, and all of that info has an effect on how they ultimately treat you.
Yeah, that's right. Jimmy Rhodes dug in and found that you have a secret customer score, and that's our featured story at the top of the list.
What if I told you that every time you shop or go out to eat, you're being graded? Because, yeah, that's happening.
Customer lifetime value is just the projected profitability that we expect to get out of a given customer.
The Wharton School's Peter Fader is a pioneer of customer lifetime value, and he's running down the basics of that secret customer score that brands are assigning you every day. Starts with simple data known as RFM, which is
frequency, monetary value. When did you last buy from us? How many purchases have you made over, let's say, the last 2 years? And how much did you spend? That's it.
Each individual company keeps its own score for each individual customer. So you have a different score for every brand using CLV. Based on those three simple RFM data points, companies decide if you're worth special treatment and perks.
You're gonna get the special members only phone number, or when you tweet at us, you're gonna get higher priority before we deal with a lower value customer.
Only shop at the store once in a while and only buy stuff that's on sale? Well, you might languish on hold for an hour while the customer with the higher CLV gets taken care of right away by a more experienced senior employee. Sounds like a competition, right? But Professor Fader says don't play the game, because there's only one way to win.
It's kind of obvious. If you buy more often, and if you buy at full price instead of buying just on the discount, that's gonna improve your lifetime value.
Look, being a high value customer is pretty frequently gonna be the exact opposite of being a smart consumer. So just try to get the best value for your dollar and forget about how companies are grading you. A couple more quick points about CLV. The way companies are using it is still evolving.
Well, high-value customers became high-value without any of that stuff. They didn't need it.
So some companies might give you perks if you're on the fence.
There's some middle-value customers who, with just one more touch, one more phone call, might become a better customer.
Finally, CLV is not for every business.
There are settings where what's right for a certain company might not be to maximize the value of its customer base, but to focus instead on the products themselves.
An obvious example is healthcare, where the customers who spend the most are the sickest, which is not a win. So does your RFM boost your CLV to make you a VIP? The time you spend on hold might be a clue. Understanding your secret customer score is at the top of the list.